Good morning, boys and girls. How have you been? I believe we've had a very great week. It's good to be in the house of the Lord today. And we want to start with Psalms 25, verse 21. May you all read together. Your perfection and faithfulness are my bodyguards, for you are my hope, and I trust in you as my only protection. Glory be to Jesus.
was so beautiful. Indeed, our God, He reigns forever and ever and ever. That's why we want to continue worshiping Him. So let's lift up our hands. Let's lift up our hearts to Him. Let's lift up our voices and let's worship the Lord.
Washing over.
thank you for rescuing us. Lord, thank you for delivering us, oh God. We've gathered this morning, Lord, to tell you thank you for the work that you did for each and every person that is here today. Lord, were it not for what you did, would have been consumed by the wicked one. But we thank you, Lord, for what you did for us. Thank you, Father. We bless your name, Lord, even for the session we've had. And Father, we pray, Lord, even as we get to hear your word this morning, that Lord, you'll minister to every boy and every girl and every person that will get to hear this. We thank you, Father, and we bless your holy name. For it's in Jesus' name we pray and we believe. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Boys and girls at home, how was praise and worship? I believe we've really enjoyed ourselves. As here, we are having good time. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Now, boys and girls, before we get to hear the word of God today, we have some of our two children who've been preparing to share the memory verse today. And at home, I want you to put your hands together as we welcome them to come and share the memory verse with boys and girls. You are most, most, most welcome.
Thank you, Teacher Andrew. Our memory verse comes from the book of James chapter 1 verse 12. It says, "Blessed are those who endure when they are tested. When they pass the test, they will receive the crown of life, which God has promised to those that love him." This is Ember Kasi Care. Bye!
Boys and girls, that was really great. I've liked the way the memory verse has been done. And of course, you'd want to know who said the memory verse today. We had Tiffany and we had Talia. Boys and girls, they've done it so well. And I want us to put our hands together and appreciate Tiffany and Talia for the good work that they have done. Yes, they've done very well, boys and girls. Now, before we get to hear the word of God today, boys and girls, today I have my two friends. As you can see, they are happy. They are happy to be in the house of God today. You know this one, this is my friend Baraka. And the far end is my friend Neema. Baraka and Neema, how are you?
Very good.
We are fine, teacher.
Good to see you today. How has been your week?
My week was excellent.
I like that. And Neoma?
My week was great.
Awesome, awesome. Boys and girls, Baraka and Neoma are going to help us to remember what we learned last Sunday, boys and girls. And I want to start with my friend Neoma. Neoma, kindly tell boys and girls the topic of our last lesson.
Teacher, before I say, I want to say why Pendo is not here.
Yes?
Pendo went to visit her shosho, and they are watching online together.
Oh, all right, that's good, thank you.
Last week, we learned on a message titled Having Faith in God. And you, teacher, you focused on the process in which we got through to make our faith in God to be strong. Yeah. Very, very, very strong.
Yes. Well then, guys, that's what we learned, the process, all right? Now, I want to ask my friend Baraka. Baraka, please tell boys and girls the Bible lesson we learned last Sunday.
Yes, teacher, I remember very well. We learned the story of Prophet Elijah.
Yes.
You know, the great man of God, he was told by God to go and hide himself by a small stream of water called, called Cherith.
Yes, you're right.
Yes, and God told him to stay there for many, many, many days. And you know what God did? He commanded some large birds called ravens to take food to him, bread and meat, every morning Every evening, the ravens fed Prophet Elijah.
Wow. Boys and girls, that's very true. That's what we learned. That's the Bible story that we learned on Sunday. And I want to ask Baraka, because I'm wondering, all these many, many days, what was he doing?
You know, because God told him to go there, I think the prophet must have been fellowshipping and praying, you know, praying to God. And he must have also been thanking God for meeting his needs.
Wow. That's very true, Baraka. Thank you for reminding boys and girls what prophet was doing in that little brook of water. Now, boys and girls, I know we are excited to be here today. And I want to ask my friend Neema to remind us our memory verse for today. I know Talia and the sister have done it very well, but I want Neema to remind us the memory verse for today. Neema?
Today, our memory verse was James 1 verse 12. Blessed are those who endure when they are tested. When they pass the test, they will receive the crown of life that God promised to show those who love him.
Wow. That's very true, boys and girls. That's what we want to be focusing today. And now, boys and girls, before I let my friends go back to their seats to sit still on their chairs and to listen, boys and girls, I want just to tell you what we're going to be learning today. Yes, we'll be continuing with our lesson, have faith in God. But today, I want you to do your hands like this. Like this, boys and girls. Yes, today we'll be learning about the power of faith. Boys and girls, see you shortly. All right, boys and girls, like I say that today we shall continue with our message, have faith in God, and today we are focusing on the power of faith. Now, today's lesson, boys and girls, is more like or less like the continuation of what we learned last Sunday, boys and girls. Now, boys and girls, allow me to start like this. I know you've seen so many people around and you've admired them. And some of the people that you've looked and admired, probably they are your class teachers. Some of them probably they're people, we call them accountants, you know. Some of them probably they're businessmen and women, people who make money through doing business. Now, boys and girls, all those people that I've mentioned, and of course some many more, they're a product of tests. Remember tests? Yes, tests. Tests. The ones like the ones that we do in class, boys and girls. Now, boys and girls, today I want to take you to our workshop like the one we had last Sunday. So please just come along with me in our workshop and we'll learn something, boys and girls. All right. Now, I know you had seen this thing here on Sunday, boys and girls. And of course, we say that this is not sufuria. This is a pot. Yes, it's used to cook food and to store water. All right. Now, boys and girls, like today you've seen, I've not come with the clay, because we had already done the bit of the process, you know. But just to remind you, when you're making a pot, boys and girls, number one, you have to, you know, to prepare the clay. You have to press the clay, you know. If clay was to feel pain, probably would tell you it is too much, you know. The pot has to put some pressure on the clay so that he can remove, you know, the stones and the air. And when he is almost done with the pot, boys and girls, you know, he has to remove the excess clay, you know. And when he is done, this clay that I'm seeing here, boys and girls, it has to be made to pass through some fire. Now, fire is not a good thing, boys and girls. I don't know whether you've been burnt by fire. Well, Teacher Andrews, that's not Teacher Andrews' prayer. Boys and girls, fire is not really a good thing, especially when it burns someone. Now, this pot I'm holding, it has to be made to pass through fire. For us to have a good pot like this, it has to go through all those things that I have mentioned, boys and girls. Now, today's lesson, boys and girls, like I said, it is the power of faith. We want to focus on what faith can do in your life. And today, boys and girls, I want us to go to the book of 1 Kings chapter 18. The book of 1 Kings chapter 18. And I will encourage you to create some time so that you can just read and get to know what is all there. Now, boys and girls, you remember this prophet we spoke about last Sunday, Prophet Elijah. Prophet Elijah is now 3 years gone. You know, he came out of the brook and he went somewhere, and 3 years are gone, and God tells him to go and face Ahab. You remember Ahab, that evil king? To go and face that king. And just because this man trusted in God, he had faith in God, he didn't tell God, "God, you know what, I will not go." He went and faced that king Ahab. And when the king met him, you know what the king told the prophet? "You troublemaker of the people of Israel." You know, he was calling Elijah a troublemaker. And in real sense, this king is the one that had caused trouble in this land. And what's the trouble here, boys and girls? The land was experiencing a very severe famine. There was no food, no rain, no water. You can imagine that kind of life. Now, boys and girls, the prophet told this king, "Now, let us go to Mount Carmel." I don't know, boys and girls, why that mountain is called Mount Carmel, but anyway, it's called Mount Carmel. He told him, "Well, get all the children of Israelites and all the prophets of Baal and Asherah, all the prophets, let's meet there, boys and girls." And I believe the following day, all these people met in that mountain, boys and girls. They met there to such a huge, huge crowd. And listen to this, boys and girls. Prophet Elijah had to explain to the people the agenda, or rather, the main reason as to why he had called all these people to come. And he told them this: "Now, today we want to test who is the true God. Because I know you've been worshiping your Baal, and I've been worshiping the true God, Jehovah God." You know, those times they used to call him Yahweh, boys and girls. Now, this was how it was going to be done. He told them, "Want to get 2 bulls. Do you know what's a bull?" "Yes, that male cow." "They want to get 2 bulls. One for the people of those who are worshiping Baal, and one was for those who worship the true God." Boys and girls, when the people heard that, they were so excited. They said, "Well, that is awesome, boys and girls." Now, this is how they were going to do it, boys and girls. This bull is going to be cut into pieces of meat, and it's going to be put on an altar. And now, the one which their God will respond by fire is going to be the God that is going to be worshipped. Now, when people heard that, they were so excited. They said, "Wow, now today we want to see who is the real God, boys and girls." And so Prophet Elijah told them this: "You want to start fast, choose the bull that you want and go fast." And they were so excited, boys and girls. They took the bull, they prepared the altar, they cut the bull, and they placed that dead bull on that altar. And from morning, can you say morning, boys and girls, to noon, imagine, they started calling on the name of their God, God of small g. Okay? Baal, hear us. But there was no response. Baal, hear us. There was no response, boys and girls. Their God is not like our God, because ours, when you call him, he answers. Now, when it got to noontime, this prophet, the servant of God, I've said he's called Prophet Elijah, tried to mock them and told them, hey, try to call him. Probably he's gone on a journey. Call him. And they went on and called him. Baal, Baal. And nothing was happening. And he still went on and told them, probably he's asleep and he must be dreaming. Call him. And they call him, but their God could not wake up and respond. You know, all sort of things were done, but the God could not respond, boys and girls. It is too sad, because he never responded at all. Now, when it got to evening, boys and girls, Prophet Elijah called the people and told them, hey, come closer. We want to see what God can do. Come closer. And people were coming closer and closer and closer. And they stood around. And by that time, the altar was already broken. No, it was in pieces. And Prophet Elijah prepared the altar. Boys and girls, he took 12 good stones, which represents the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. And he put some wood on it, boys and girls. And he took his bull. Now, this bull, we want to call it a burnt sacrifice, because Prophet Elijah was giving this to the Lord, boys and girls. And so he told people, hey, put some water on this, boys and girls. They put water on that altar. The first round, the second round, and even the third round, boys and girls. And that water went all around. There was a trench that was dug around that water. And so the water even filled the trench around that water, that altar, boys and girls. Now, listen to this. Prophet Elijah didn't have dramas like the other guys. He just lifted his eyes and he calls the name of his Lord. It just in some simple language, boys and girls, some simple words. He said, God, I call on your name, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I call on you today. May you reveal yourself as the real God, the true God. And may these people today know that you are their God and I am your servant. Show yourself. Boys and girls, soon he was done with the prayer. A huge fire came down and it consumed the burnt sacrifice, those pieces of meat, boys and girls. It consumed the wood, it consumed the stones, and even the water that was around that altar on the trench. Boys and girls, it licked all that water and nothing was left. Boys and girls, if I may ask, who is the true God in this case? Is it the God of the Baal, who never responded, was called almost the whole day, or the God of Prophet Elijah? Who is the true God? Boys and girls, I know you've already gotten the answer. The God who answered by fire was the God of Elijah, boys and girls. And people came down and they worshipped God. They said, the Lord is God. The Lord is God. The Lord is God that day. Everyone said, the Lord is God. And you know what? The story didn't end there. Prophet Elijah got hold of all those false prophets of Baal. He took them to a certain river and he killed all of them. All of them, boys and girls, that day. And boys and girls, listen to this. He now went to the mountain, the same mountain, at the top of it, Mountain Carmel, boys and girls. He went there and he prayed. He went with his servant, he knelt down and he prayed. The first time he prayed, asking God to bring the rains, there was nothing. And the servant of Prophet Elijah told the Elijah, you know, there's nothing. He went and checked until the seventh round, boys and girls. He came back and told the prophet, hey, I've seen a little bit of cloud like the hand of a man. And soon after that, boys and girls, the entire cloud turned dark and a lot of rain came down that day, boys and girls. And that is the God that we worship, boys and girls. Now, listen to this. This kind of faith that Prophet Elijah had, I would call it a powerful kind of faith. Now, boys and girls, when we go through some challenging moments in life, some difficult moments in life, those are the processes that we're talking last Sunday. Those processes make our faith stronger and stronger and stronger. Just like Nehemiah was telling us today. Yes, it becomes stronger and stronger and stronger, boys and girls. So when we go through some difficult moment, that is not the time to say, God is not here. God is not hearing my prayer. No, God is always there with his people, just like he was with this prophet Elijah at the brook. Remember, one of the challenges we mentioned is separation. He was separated. He wasn't seeing his good friends, his fellow prophets, but he used that moment to seek the face of God. You remember what Baraka told us today? When Prophet Elijah was alone in that brook, well, he was praying and even listening to what God is saying, boys and girls. Now, I want to give you a small, small homework, boys and girls. If you have your pen, you can just write it down, okay? You can write down some few things that have been like a challenge in your life. Yes, probably you've been trusting God for something and it has not come forth. Just write it down, boys and girls. It could be one or two, boys and girls, just write them down. And secondly, I encourage you to separate yourself, set some time and seek God. You can pray just a simple prayer. Ask God, God, what are you saying about this situation that I have? Because our God is like the God of Elijah. Our God is going to speak to you, boys and girls. I know, I'm so sure about that. Yes, he will speak to you. Write down the things that the Lord is talking to you. Write them down. He may give you some instructions, you know, the things to do for you to do. Write down those things that he has told you to do and take action, boys and girls. Yes, as we go through some issues in life, that's not the time to put our faith down. That is the moment to know that the Lord is working inside of us. Our faith is being made stronger day by day. Praise the Lord. Boys and girls, I want to pray. And I know at home you've been sitting. I will encourage you to stand up on your feet because I want to pray with you. I want to pray with you because I know we'll be hearing some powerful testimonies of what the power in faith can do in our lives, just like it did to this prophet Elijah, boys and girls. Let me pray. Father, we thank you, Lord, for the story of Prophet Elijah, who went through some moment of separation at the brook Cherith. And out of that, Lord, you build up his faith. And when he was meeting all these people who were worshiping false gods, He was sure because of his faith in you. He was sure that God, you're going to show these people by answering with an evidence of fire. He didn't doubt about that because his faith was made strong through the challenge and the difficult moment that he went through. We thank you, Father, and we pray that this word will establish some mega faith in boys and girls. Father, we thank you and we bless your name, for it's in Jesus' name we pray and we believe. Amen, amen, amen. Boys and girls, as we come to the end, I want to encourage us to engage our parents to help us to give God's tithe and offering. And secondly, our teachers have prepared some nice materials which have been put in our church website. Encourage your parents to get there. Let them be downloaded during the week and ensure you watch those video clips and make sure that you do those coloring activities. And as you do that, it's going to be a blessing to you. It will help you to know the lesson of today. And lastly, for our big class, the 11 to 13 boys and girls, we encourage you on Saturday, the normal time, engage with your teachers. I believe as we do that, it's going to be great. Boys and girls, I'm looking forward to see you next Sunday with another lesson. God bless you. Thank you very much. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you.